In the previous video, I began assembling the X and Y axes of my new CNC machine, and in this video I will make the Z axis plates and mount a spindle. I'm currently cutting the top and bottom plates, which will hold the bearing and Acme lead screw between a 25cm length of aluminium C-beam and a stepper motor on the top. You may have noticed I don't use any over-engineered clamping methods, because, well, the screw has stood the test of time. The helical thread applies a tremendous amount of clamping pressure, and they rarely vibrate loose. Because I also use two wasteboards, a sub-wasteboard and a sacrificial one that I can level, when they are both bolted together, this increases the rigidity of the platform. By not treating the wasteboard like consecrated ground, I can clamp through holes and openings of parts, reducing waste and achieving cuts other CNC clamps would make impossible, such as the PTFE nut block in a previous video. This piece on screen now contains two parallel channels which will hold the 80mm spindle mounts, which I am cutting from 18mm birch ply. I secured my material, centered the bit, and began cutting. The first was cut square, but I decided this occupied too much space and tapered the second. To save myself from cutting the first out again, I mirrored and cut these angles on my miter saw. These mounting plates fit nicely into the channels, and when the spindle is slid in place, this should hold everything square. I've already tested whether the lead screw can take the weight of the new spindle by balancing it on the Z axis of my old machine. I decided to incorporate extraction into the clamping part of the spindle mount. This will be in the form of a 50mm clear acrylic tube, which I can attach a hanging hose to. Perching next to the CNC machine with an extraction nozzle playing catch the sawdust will not stand the test of time. That said, I'm not sure if my idea is going to work. I'd like to add a pin to the acrylic tube, which can let the dust shoe rest upon the working material, however lift when the bit plunges. I'm going to have to save this for another video, but that's the idea for now. I'm now assembling the spindle mount, beginning by gluing the horizontal mounts to the vertical plate. I clamped and gently knocked the pieces into position, flipped the assembled part and drove several screws in the rear. So I'm going to put the wheels now on the back of this plate. They're going to be the same as these on the Y plate. I'm not going to repeat myself, but I'll provide a link to how these were installed with the spacings in the information card. Once the wheels were installed, I adjusted the eccentric spacer so the plate would fit onto the C-beam. I then placed a blank PTFE nut block onto the rear of the spindle mounting assembly. I then flipped the machine to its side and installed the bottom Z-axis plate. I returned the spindle mounting assembly onto the C-beam, and with the top Z-axis plate in place, I used a transfer punch placed through the hole of the bearing to mark the position of the lead screw on the PTFE. I drilled and tapped this and assembled everything back onto the Z axis, along with the aluminium shim and lead screw locking collars. Because I've yet to install the stepper motor, the weight of the spindle and low resistance of the nut block is forcing the lead screw to turn and the spindle to drop. So I've got three trapezoidal screws here. One is the original 8mm trapezoidal screw that was on the upgrade to the X-carve. This one is the offcut from the one that I made the tap. And this is a slightly cheaper one I bought on eBay. And they're all slightly different. The cheaper one on the right from eBay has a square thread. The original on the left seems to have a round thread, or a worn out trapezoidal one, and the middle one seems like, well, the middle one, with a trapezoidal thread. All fit on the Delrin nut block which came with the C-beam linear actuator, and the trapezoidal and round thread fit on the nut block I made with both the trapezoidal and square thread taps. but the square threaded lead screw doesn't fit on the one I made with the trapezoidal tap. In short, it's important to source all your lead screws from the same place, and preferably buy them at the same time in case there are subtle differences.
The reason I've taken the spindle off and taken the lead screw off this one here is I'm planning to use the smaller open builds locking collars on the bottom of the Z-axis on both the new machine, which is to my left, and the older machine, which is behind me. And then the larger couplers, which are a bit too large for the Z-axis, can go on the top, where they're less likely to hit on the wheels.
The last thing left to do is the mounting clamps. I drilled a shallow, large hole using the Forstner bit for the head of the machine screws, and a 5.5mm hole all the way through the centre of that.
Okay, so I've drilled out a countersunk hole and also piloted it so I can use these machine screws to hold the spindle in place. And what I'm going to do is actually tap the ply. So I'm using a 4.2mm bit to help me find the center of the hole. I've got a transfer punch. Just making sure the thread is nice and clean. Definitely screwing in.
Just in case the thread doesn't hold, I could paint the inside thread with wet rot hardener, slightly swelling and toughening the ply. I tried installing the machine screws without this and they seemed to bite, but I really can't undo this too often. So that's the X, Y and Z axis of the CNC machine assembled, and I'm quite happy with the progress. It seems sturdy and the birch ply plates are quite striking too. So in the next video I will install the motors on their raised spacers and wire those up, as well as a water-cooled spindle to a variable frequency drive. I should also start thinking about cable management. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and here are the usual links.